Next will be Haley Pasquale. Thank you.
Thank you. My name's John Prendergast, and I'm the supervisor for the town of Benton, Yates County. So the town of Benton is the township just north of the town of Torrey. I'm in full support of this project. I've heard the stories here tonight. I've lived on Seneca Lake and grown up in this area. I've lived on the lake for some 25-plus years. I was employed by Ferro Corporation, which is just south of the plant, the Greenwich plant, from 1968 to 2007. And from 2007 to 2014, when I retired, I was with Clarkson University. Now, my background with that plant is that I have a background in engineering, I have a degree in chemistry from Hobart, and an MBA from the University of Rochester Science School. Over the period of time at the plant, from 68 to 2007, New York State Electric and Gas, later AES, were very, very sound corporate members, responsible members of the community. We worked together with them as corporations and so forth. At that plant, while I was there, I had charge of everything from operations to research and development to sales internationally, et cetera, to the semiconductor industry, to the photovoltaic industry around the world, and so forth. So I have a strong background in that. At Clarkson University, I ran a research center for advanced materials processing, and when I left there in 2014, I ran for supervisor and have been that in a part-time basis for the last 2 years and was re-elected again to do so for another couple of years. Economic development here in this town, this county, is important. I hear people come from Ithaca and everything, thank you very much. But I'm telling you that we have people that we have to serve, we have taxes that have to be paid, we have schools that we have to support, and we have municipalities. That, yes, this is an agricultural community. It's a beautiful area. That's why we live here. We're blessed. Some of us were born here into it. Some of us moved here. But we have to support it. And that support comes with jobs. Now, if you want to use renewable energy, get the hell out there and put it on your roof today. Go ahead, support it. But don't tell us we don't need a power plant to back that up. Now, I hear people say, well, how in the last 10 years, energy has gone down, the consumption down in New York City. We don't need this power plant. Well, you know why it's gone down? Because every time somebody retires from New York State, they get the hell out because they can't afford the taxes. I'm telling you, folks, you need this plant. I'm fully supporting it, and that's my position. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Haley Pasquale. I'm from Livingston County. I'm a previous student at FLCC, a future student at Warren Wilson College. And I'm going to make it very simple and just say that I oppose the project, very much so, because I oppose fossil fuels and I support renewable energy. And I'd love to have a second hearing to elaborate more on my statements. So thank you very much.
People, there is information on how to submit your comments electronically, email, phone. Is Marty Dodge here? After him will be Michael Davis.
Hello, greetings. Too close, too far. Marty Dodge, Canandaigua, a bunch of years, taught at Finger Lakes Community College, Natural Resources Conservation and Marine Environmental Science, Solar Energy Applications, Alternative Energies, and Global Sustainability. And that's my point. We are in serious trouble. Now, it's bad for business, it's bad for economics, it's bad for politics, but the truth, folks, The IPCC reports keep coming out. They get worse and worse. The Lester Browns, the Bill McKibbins, the numbers people, the scientists are shaking their heads. Wartime speed away from fossil fuel issues. The methane is burping out of the tundra. The methane hydrate in the bottoms of the oceans is coming up. You see that 75-minute calving of icebergs in Greenland. The oceans are acidifying at a rate where shellfish can no longer put their shells down. And it goes on and on. 2 degrees centigrade, that's the limit. 3 degrees, trouble. That business as usual, fossil fuel development, as we're talking about, could conceivably result in the loss of half of the world's species within the next 30 or 40 years, and temperatures that are absolutely unbearable. Not just a little hot. If it, according to the Evergreen College professor, if it goes up 10 degrees, which is possible by the year 2000, well, a couple hundred years, we're talking temperatures of too hot to stand outside, 180 degrees. And we poo-poo, nobody believes that it's not going to happen. But I'm convinced, I'm concerned. I've done a lot of reading, and I continue to look at it, and I continue to be really concerned about business as usual being carried on. And I, as obviously, don't support the development of a natural gas plant here in Dresden. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Michael Davis. I'm with the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers. I am 100% for solar power. I'm 100% for wind power. I am for a hamster on a wheel as long as we put the wheel in and the labor runs as a hamster. That's the way that happens where we are. But I want to talk about reality. And I want to ask these people in the back who install this stuff for a living these questions. Reality. Can a facility the size of PAC 600 people run on solar or wind power? No. Can it run on that?
No.
Can soldiers in Sailors, no, not at this point in time. Can soldiers in Sailors Hospital and Geneva General Hospital run on solar and wind power alone?
Yes.
They can.
Yes.
Feasibly, economically, right this second, you can do that.
Yes.
I'm afraid not. Not in state of business in this area. I'm sorry. Maybe the hospitals can, but there's no way a factory can. And I'm going to tell you why, because I also sit on a bunch of boards in this area. One of the factories in this area every year asks for government subsidies because the cost of power in this area is too much. And they threaten to leave, and they have 600 employees. And that is reality in this area. I don't know why everybody says it isn't true, because it is. I sit on a board that hears it every year. We have to leave, the cost of power is too much. Now we have the ability to have something with peak power come back in. Our local has been in business since 1918. They brought this plant out of the ground. They maintained this plant until it was closed. This plant is a facility, as Ben said, has come out of mothballs in perfect condition. The reason why is from the gentleman in the back. And I want you to understand, it's not mutually exclusive to Love Seneca Lake in this area and actually work in places like that, because every gentleman in the back room also hunts, fishes, and does everything else in this area, the same as everyone else. And they would not install or do anything to hurt that. That's reality. Support it more quickly. Thank you.
Bill Kitchen present?
Yes, but I'll let other people go in front of me.
Okay. Peter Drobny?